Hi everyone, my name is Nick. I'm one of the carnivore keepers here at Auckland Zoo. And so the five domains of welfare feed into everything that we do here at the zoo in regards to looking after our animals and giving them the best possible welfare that we can. So first thing we're going to do today is we're going to feed our otter family. Now, because of their physiology, there's a science to how we feed these guys. They've got a very high metabolism, which means they need to feed them at a high frequency through the day. Now we feed them lots of lean protein, which just fills them up longer. And we give them all sorts of different things. So we've got some hard shell crab. So all this really good chitinous material is good for their digestive system. It's really good for their dentition. And it just makes sure that they get as much of a natural diet as possible. So we come into their habitat a couple of times a day and we give them a massive big variety of their favorite seafoods. I'm gonna head out of here now, let our family out and let them enjoy their breakfast. Hey Dash! Come on, Dash, Dash. So next up, we're gonna be doing some training with our female Tasmanian devil. So in particular, we're gonna do some injection training with her. And that just enabled us to get a bit closer to her, desensitizes her to be able to give her some vaccinations or any medication. Or if we ever need to do an anesthetic, it just enables us to get a bit closer to her under a stress-free environment. And that way we can have a good look at her and see if there's anything that we can do for her. You ready? Come on, Dash. Come on. So we're just inside our Tasmanian devil house now. So you can see Dash is waiting to get some food. So what I'm doing is I'm just giving her little bits of chicken as sort of a food reward. It enables me to get really close to her just so I can have a really good look at her, make sure that she is in tip-top shape. And then I've got a little needle here with just the kept syringe. And then what we do is we just gently prod them in the thigh muscle just to desensitize them to that sensation. And then the further we get down the road with our training sessions, that's when we can start to sort of really give them a bit more push with it, and then we can sort of give them the vaccinations and medications and whatever we need to. And so the great thing about all of our training is it's completely voluntary, so the animals choose to partake in them, so it's a complete stress-free environment. As you can see, she's getting some nice little treats. So it's really important that we can do these sort of training sessions so that if we do need to do an anesthetic, we can give her the injection, which will send her to sleep nice and peacefully, nice and calm. We can do what we need to do, and then she wakes up nice and happy. Well done. So as always, we like to finish our training sessions with a nice little treat. So she's got a nice big piece of rabbit. Oh, good girl. She's the first one that we actually decided to try injection training with, and she's just done incredibly well. And I'm just really proud of where she's got to. I love her, love her. Ugh. Hey, Dala. Where are you? Oh. Hello, little one. So environment is one of our welfare domains. So we're here with our red panda. And as you can see, there's a lot of trees, there's a lot of branches. Because red panda are pretty much an arboreal species, which means that they spend most of their time up in the tree. They like to sleep up in the trees. You might see our pandas curled around some of the branches and stuff. So having heaps of different opportunities is just a lot better for these guys. In the wild, they would rarely come down to the ground because that's when they're most susceptible to predators. So it's really important here at Auckland Zoo that we can give them a lot of opportunities where they can be high up, they can come across, and there's a lot of branch, a lot of pathways. Just knowing that when I come to work, I can give these guys the best possible care that I can offer to them and enrich their quality of life is what I do come to work for. I get to spend every day with some amazing creatures, some amazing people, create habitats where they can exhibit as many natural behaviors as possible, and also give them the best quality of life.